startled me.
I didn't see you there. I fell asleep looking at this book we made a long time ago. Did I ever tell you about my comic book store? I started it when I was 17 years old in 1993.
It all began with my high school economic stock market game. I bought Marvel stock at school and invested some of my own savings in real life. My Marvel stock did great. I won the game and got a trophy.
I sold the stock in real life too. Made some money on it. I was thinking all the fun ways I could spend that money. And I thought, I'll open up a comic book store and name it Tate's Comics, after me, Tate.
We cut the ribbon on my first location in South Florida in March of 93. Only 1,000 square feet. A 17-year-old kid opening his own business was newsworthy, and we had some newspaper articles written on us. We grew a lot over the years, and by 2008, my store was a 6,800-square-foot pop culture mecca. We had a huge selection of comic books, back issues, and graphic novels, and it didn't stop there. We always evolved and added new, fun merchandise that kept our customer base growing. We had all kinds of cool stuff, like indie self-published comics and alternative graphic novels, children's books, and kids' comics. I loved their art book selection. Lowbrow, fantasy, comic, and illustration. We had all kinds. We had lots of toys too, from Star Wars and Transformers to designer vinyl art toys. Everyone loved our selection of Japanese products. We had tons of Japanese snacks. Shelves and shelves of manga. A wide variety of anime DVDs, and lots more too. We always did our best to help out the local comic creators. There was a big section devoted to drawing books and supplies. There was a community art board, and we carried the comic books that they made. We shelved their books right next to Marvel and DC. I had the best employees back then. Each were experts in different areas of the store. That was one of the reasons we had such a great variety. We constantly tried new things to reach out and bring the community into the store. We always said that if we got you in the door, you'd come back and bring friends. One fun event we held was Geek Singles Night.
Tonight it's all about the geeks here inside Tate's. It is Geek Dating Night. Inside these doors, geeks are hoping to find love.
People had a chance to make new friends and flirt a little bit while speed dating among the comics. Oh, did I mention that we also had an art gallery? We held shows there every month. Lots of people who came by said they'd never been in an art gallery before. We also had these shows that were open to all local artists. Those were crazy, with over 200 artists participating in some of them. We also did these free Japanese snack tastings a couple times a year. Hundreds of people would come out to try all kinds of weird stuff. Oh yeah, free comic book day. Every year we gave away thousands of comic books on that special day to our customers and the local libraries.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Tate sale is now officially open!
Twice a year we had great big tent sales. One year, for our 15th anniversary, we had an Olympic theme. They were fun events, like the long box toss. The box was really filled with comics and weighed nearly 50 pounds. My store is dog friendly. People came in with their pets all the time. We gave away free comics and stickers to kids year round. That always put a smile on their faces. To keep a few more plastic bags out of landfills, we started our Save a Plastic Tree initiative. Our customers brought in their clean but used shopping bags and we reused them at the store. We featured special customers in our Extraordinary Customer of the Month program. Unfortunately, we had a wall of shame too. Photos of shoplifters we've banned were posted up for all to see. One of my favorite charities was Humane Society's Walk for the Animals. We raised money for donation and walked in a giant pack together every year. It was important to me that my store had a unique look. I wanted people to say, wow, when they walked in the door. We had robots with wings that watched over us and huge gears above the checkout counter. The store was huge and had so many different things for sale. We tried to organize it with crossover appeal. Manga was in the front by the anime and Japanese stuff, and our graphic novels were next to the new comics and back issues. I have some pictures here in this book. It'd be easier for me to show you than to explain it all. Here's one of me at the checkout counter. I look so young! This was the new comic wall. They were in alphabetical order by title. And each week, they moved over here to the recent comic wall. Eventually, they moved into the back issue bins. This was our graphic novel section. Like the comics, they were alphabetized by title. There's so much more I have to show you. This is barely the tip of the iceberg.
Who are you talking to, Mr. Otani?
Nobody?
It's time for your sponge bath.
Ooh.